Here is the date of the X-ray done, name of the person, and his identification number. And then here it's a properly done, because all these are uprights, and this is placed in anatomical, this anterior, posterior, and lateral view. Now I will read the X-ray in proper manner. So these are the plain X-rays of leg, written here left. So it's the left leg, anterior, posterior, and lateral views, showing up to the proximal leg, tibia and fibula, and ankle mortis, and part of the foot, in both the views of a skeletally mature person. It is a skeletally mature person because there is no open physis. Here you can see a few physial scar. So with the pathology mainly lies on the both tibia and fibula at the junction of middle and distal third. So there is a breach in the continuity of the both tibia and fibula. So it is a fracture which is oblique. It is an oblique fracture with the lateral displacement. So my lateral displacement in anterior posterior view and posterior angulation and anterior displacement, and posterior angulation in lateral view with the apex anteriorly. So it's a fracture both bone, left leg of a mature skeleton at the junction of middle and distal third, which is displaced laterally and anteriorly with posterior angulation apex anteriorly. So this is how you read this X-ray. Now I'll put the other X-ray. These are the plain X-rays with adequate exposure with all the details here. And it's a X-ray, plain X-rays of thigh, anterior, posterior, and lateral views, showing hip joint and part of the pelvis up to the distal thigh in both the views of a mature skeleton. So there is no open physis, so mature skeleton with main pathologies mainly lie at the junction of proximal and middle third of the shaft of femur. So it's a basically diaphyseal with the breach in continuity of the femur. So it is a fracture. There is a multiple small fragment, at least more than two, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is a 4 fragment. So it is a comminuted fracture of proximal femur, and there is a displacement. This is anterior posterior view. There is displacement is not in medial. This is medial part, no, medial and lateral part. There is no displacement, but there is medial angulation. This distal part is angulated medially with apex laterally. Medial angulation in the epi view, and in lateral view, the distal fragment has gone posteriorly, because this is ischial tuberosity, which lies posterior of the femur. So it shows that the distal fragment has displaced posteriorly with the proximal migration of the distal fragment. So there is it's angulated anteriorly. So you can say it's a comminuted fracture of proximal shaft of proximal femur, comminuted fracture of shaft of femur with the posterior displacement of the distal fragment and anteromedial angulation. It's anterior, this anterior angulation, and it's a medial angle, anteromedial angulation with apex posteriorly with the shortening. There is a proximal migration with the shortening. So this is the comminuted fracture of proximal femur with displacement. Simply you can say displaced comminuted proximal shaft of femur. You can simply say that, like that, of a mature person. So there are certain named fracture in orthopedics, and this is one of them. So these are the plain x-rays of elbow joint showing distal humerus, radius and ulna of a skeletally mature person, which shows pathology mainly lies at the proximal ulna, which shows break in continuity at the proximal ulna. So that is fracture of the proximal ulna, and other pathology is in the elbow joint. Here radiocapsular joint is dislocated, the radius is dislocated from its joint. So it is the fracture of proximal ulna with dislocation of the radioulnar joint. So it's a dislocation of the radioulnar joint, proximal radioulnar joint. So it is called the Montegia fracture dislocation. Montegia fracture dislocation. So here now the displacement here in this case, the proximal, the distal fragment has shifted laterally and angulated medially, distal fragment in anteroposterior view, and in lateral view this distal fragment has angulated posteriorly with the apex anteriorly. Okay, so and this radioulnar joint is dislocated anteriorly. So this is the Montegia fracture dislocation, and it's a type 1 Montegia fracture dislocation.